Hello and welcome back to the garage. Today we are going to explore the process of programming ESP32 module for the Tesla Open Inverter board that I designed myself. Well, I hope all three of you that will be watching will find this tutorial helpful. However, let's dive into the programming and see how can we get the Tesla board up and running. But before we start, just a quick recap of what happened previously on the channel. I've successfully made a Tesla motor spin using Open Inverter board. Now I'm working on my own variant with some improvements. One of the key changes is the introduction of the new ESP32 Wi-Fi module. I've faced some challenges getting it to work, so I've decided to create this tutorial to help others who might have the same problems. All Open Inverter designs use ESP8266 web-based interface to adjust key parameters in the inverter setup. This makes it a very important component of all Open Inverter boards. In my previous builds, I used OLIMAX and VMOS modules. Unfortunately, I have found OLIMAX modules difficult to program, while VMOS were difficult to mount on the Open Inverter board. In my current design, I'm using ESP32 Wroom module and integrating it directly into the board instead. To minimize the cost, I'm using an external USB to UART module from SparkFun to program the board. But don't worry, the programming method covered in this tutorial applies to any USB-based ESP32 board. Unfortunately, initially I didn't think through the design and I assigned the same UART channel to communicate with the STM32 controller and to program ESP32 module as well. I need to ensure there is no data collision during the programming phase, so fortunately I've included configurable links in my design. I'm going to cut through the links to disconnect STM32 chip to prioritize the ESP module. These tracks can be resoldered later. Now I can connect USB to serial converter and begin programming. I have connected the transmit pin from SparkFun module to the receive pin on my board and vice versa, receive pin of the SparkFun to the transmit pin on my board. And of course I've connected the 5 volts and the ground. And last thing I need to do is to connect the link. The link between the ground and IO0 will allow us to place the ESP module in the boot mode so that we can start programming. Okay, so now we need to move to the computer. As a next step, all I need to do is connect my board to the USB port. So I just plugged in the board and as you can see the code has been executed because we are getting 5 volts from USB through this regulator and it powers on the STM32 processor. So now we are ready to program the module and we have Platform.io project open and I've got the project files in here. I'm navigating to Platform.io symbol and at this step you need to select Platform.io core CLI. So CLI in this case stands for command line interface. So once our cursor is active here, we can send the command to list all devices. So the command is PIO device list. We can see the devices which are present on our computer. And in this case, we are only interested in COM5. So COM5 is the one connected to the serial to USB converter. I should mention that Platform.io does include a file which is called Platform.io local override. This file gives you opportunity to specify your configuration to upload the code. I have it opened already. We can see where this file is located. And the original download actually called Platform.io your local override.example. So what you need to do is you need to rename the .example into .ini file. And in this case, I simply specify the COM port 5 for upload and I specify COM 5 for monitor. So this should work and all I need to do now is type upload command. First upload command is as follows. PIO space run space minus minus target space upload and enter. And at this point, you should see that the program will start to compile and build. Now we can see that Platform.io starts to write some data into our ESP32. Hooray! And we can see that USB to serial converter happily flashing its LED and we do have a success. So that's half of the job done. So what do we do next? At that stage, we need to actually disconnect our USB to serial converter. In my case, it's quite easy to do, so I have disconnected it. Now I'm connecting it and making sure that all the wires properly plugged in. And now we need to do a second part of the upload. And command is exactly the same, except the last two letters should be FS. So upload FS and it's writing again. Hopefully this time it is also a success. So that's pretty much it, all we need to do to program ESP32. So now I will go back to the board and I will resolder my links that I initially cut out. I quickly resoldered the links and verified with my DVM that connection was good and ready for testing. An open circuit. And of course these ones are connected. Okay, so that's good. Now we're ready to actually test ESP32. So the board is on and at this point ESP32 should be working. And if it's working, we should be able to reach it on its IP address. Now let's move to the computer. So I'm back at the computer now. And as we can see on Johannes Hubner GitHub webpage, the IP address is the one we need on here. But before we go to the IP address, we will need to connect our ESP32 to the Wi-Fi connection point. It's actually called as ESP and the number. The numbers can vary for each individual module, but I have already connected this one and it's mine. All I'm going to do now is just going to click this link and it's working. And here we go, web page is loaded and it's constantly refreshing. Look at this, Johannes made fantastic new design for the web interface. I can go to parameters and I can see there are some parameters on here, so we can submit them, download, restore, etc. So that's a confirmation that Open Inverter board is working and communication between STM32 and ASP have been established. Of course, there is no connection to the Tesla inverter, but at least I know that UI part of my setup is working. So this completes the programming bit of the Open Inverter webpage interface for the ESP32. I have to say, I find that ESP32 is really so much easier to work with than the previous variants of ESP8266. I'm glad that I used it in my new Tesla board design. And that's a wrap on the programming of the ESP32 module for our Open Inverter board. Now, before you go, just remember, like our trusty ESP32, YouTube algorithm is always listening. But unlike our ESP32, it doesn't need a firmware update to know what you like. So if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, who knows? Maybe the AI overloads will reward you with more awesome content. Until next time, happy Tesla ESP32 programming!